Greetings, we have come a long way to hear and learned most of the tools. Now we are going to learn column tool, which one of the last tools. Let's go to the column tool, which is located here, and place the floor plan. This is the simplest one. Now let's go to the column tool again, and this time click this tool and click the floor plan, but we need to click second time for this. This will make slot column between. Third and last one is rotated one. I think it isn't so important because we can rotate this after place too. Let's click this one. As you can see, we have settings here. For instance, bottom and top offset. Let's go to 3D. Click the column. Here this part you are going to see these size settings. You can make this column shape uniform or tempered. You need to change these values and you need to unlink them to change for separately. Or you can change this shape directly from 3D. Click this point and click this command, just drag it or enter a value. The change between two values was automatically broken once we did this, and these distances was changed. Here this part you can change top angle. Click this and enter an angle here. I'm gonna input 45. By clicking this, this angle can be changed too. To change the bottom part, you are going to use this one. I'm gonna input 45 again. Once you click this blue line point, the slope of the column can be totally changed. We have placed the column. Now we are going to change its properties. Hit this button. As you can see, there are structure options. If you click this, you will have created a shell level on the current one. Both of these levels' materials can be changed separately. To change the shell part thickness, you need to use this box and this box for the structure type. If you want to make a cylindrical column, just use this one. Coating was also changed with main one. With this button, you can use any profile for your columns. After click this, you will select what you need. For instance, I'm gonna select this. Let's zoom in. Here are profile points and used for stretching. Or stretching this way. Let's get rid of these, which we have finished our job. Now we are going to do more exciting one. Let's place a basic column. Click this and press Ctrl plus T. Here we have our new options menu that has got main changings part, top height, top link, winner and slope. This changes reference point, and this change top and bottom angle, and this is the layer. This part is more important. It is about the designing. This changes the floor plan and cut visibility. Let's go back to segment part. Hit this one and multiple structure type will be opened. Click this add a couple of times and you will see parts here. These parts have their own settings and can be changed separately. Let's call this 100 cm. Click this and input here 100. And same for this. Once we have this, we are going to select 300 cm for total height. Unfortunately, I cannot select these parts directly from here. It would be nice though. Let's go here and change this value, for instance, 50. And make this one tapered from here. I throw it completely. Get 50 cm. I go to this one and make 20 for this. I make this one 25. For the last one, 50 cm for the height and 35 cm for this distance. And turn this into cylindrical one, or for the others too. Let's again change this to 25 cm. We have got this a 3D view. Click this and press Ctrl plus T and click this profile. Let's select one of these. For example, this one and OK. This is our multi-separated column. Let's click this point. We can change the position of this in 3D. Let's change this too and create another point by clicking here. These changings are changed from main window too. Let's go to the third part. And change this distance 28 cm. If you click this, both part of the column will be reversed. As our column design is parametric, its slope and height can be changed totally without disturbing the parts. Like this. Let's do an interesting shape. I just press Ctrl plus U for multiply and click rotate. Uncheck this and OK. I'm gonna click a center point and click the column, then click the rotated angle. It didn't happen because I have forgot something. To click this, click OK. Doing same steps again, clicking center and define the angle and complete the shape, then click anywhere. Examples can be reproduced. Let's go to elevation. We are going to do same changes here. I'm gonna click one of these. As you can see, we have options here. Stretch height, with fixed angle, and modify angle. Let's try this one firstly. I'm moving the mouse, but it doesn't move correctly. It has to stretch my mouse position, but it hasn't. To fix this, we are going to go to settings and change this into person type. So we remove the locks. Now we can stretch this column easily. But this one can't be changed. This is the other stretching type that moves into blue axis. That was all it for this. Thank you for watching. See you at the next one.